What has impressed you the most about Tino in his time here?
You know, he has a very strong football background, which means he is into the game of football, and that, you know, for a quarterback is really important. You know, we do a lot of things in meetings where it's, yes, it is related to what we do, but a lot of it is about understanding why we do things. And one of the questions I always asked him, the day after there's been a game on TV, see anything on TV that's of interest? Not the plays, but what happened in the game, situations, why would they use a timeout there? You know, why wouldn't they use a timeout there? And things like that, and he's really into that, beside the fact he's into football.
He says that he's got the full playbook at his disposal. Does that just show you how smart he is in the meeting rooms when he's here, when he's looking things at film, that you've got the confidence that you can give it to him?
He's been here like a year and a half. I mean, if he didn't have a chance to run what we plan on doing, then, you know, it would be bad on our part and his part. But, you know, no, he's, like I would say, you know, we go into every game looking to see what we think we can do against the other team. Now, yeah, the player involved is part of that equation. But, you know, we haven't, you know, scaled back what our thoughts were. I mean, because a couple of weeks ago, we didn't know for sure whether Darian was going to play or not. Tino took all the reps on two of the days.
Does he bring anything different to the table that Darian doesn't bring?
Well, he brings a lack of experience, but no. No, you know, until Tino plays a lot in some games, that'll be hard to answer.
How much does the ability of the different player impact your play calling from Darian Durant to Tino Cesari?
You know, that just depends how the game's going. You know, the flow of the game, it probably impacts play calling more than anything. Now, yes, certain players do certain things, and you always build to their strength. But, you know, that's like saying, what will you do if it snows tomorrow? You'll know when it snows. You know, so, you know, the flow of the game impacts those things way more than sometimes the personality of the players.
Are you a coach who asks the quarterbacks, you know, what plays they feel comfortable with to kind of get a feeling for where their head's at and where they're comfortable?
We spend a whole day of our meetings. We do nothing but go. I give them a homework assignment on the second day, and on the third day, one of the quarterbacks is on the board, and we go through all the categories there, and they are supposed to have filled in the blanks with what they like, and, you know, and sometimes I throw rocks at the plays, and sometimes I say they're good plays, you know. But that's part of understanding what we are trying to accomplish and them to understand that better.
How does Tino do?
They all do very well. I'm impressed with the guys.
George, obviously your MO wouldn't change if it was Darian, Seth, and there. It's still a run-first offense.
Well, it's whatever we think is best for us to move the ball and win the game. I mean, we start every game with the same goal, make a first down, and then after we make a first down, then we'll go from there. But, yeah, it's whatever we think's best, and we've ran the ball very well this year.
Developed some pretty good quarterbacks over the years. Is that part of the enjoyment of the job, the satisfaction? How much satisfaction in, you know, developing a quarterback such as Tino Cesari?
Well, you know, I don't know. Tino played at a pretty high level before he came here. I don't know if we developed Tino or not. But, you know, the satisfaction is winning games and, you know, having players play well. You know, I always said I'm going to use another player's example. I coached Aaron Rodgers for a couple of years. Aaron Rodgers was not recruited out of high school by any college. Okay, he's a pretty fair player. And I asked him after a year or two, I said, what the heck was the deal? I said, because I know we didn't turn you into a player. You were a pretty good player when you came here, and nobody recruited him out of high school, which tells you how hit or miss that whole operation is. But, you know, guys that have inherent talent and they're driven to be good usually become good.